all in violation 2903.1182, all felonies of the first degree. Counsel had asked for the preparation of a pre-sentence investigation report. I'm in receipt of that report. I've made it available to the state of Ohio as well as defense counsel. The court is prepared to go forward. Is the state of Ohio prepared to go forward?
Yes, Your Honor.
Counsel, are you prepared to go forward?
I am, Your Honor.
And would the state like to be heard?
Yes, Your Honor. First and foremost, the state would like to thank the officers involved in this case. There were three different agencies involved, the Ohio State Highway Patrol. So the state is thankful for Trooper Matthew Dowlers and Trooper Anthony Bowsey's investigation and their professionalism throughout this case. In addition, there were officers Eric Brown and Chris Monk from Newburgh Heights Police Department, and Kevin Stack and Officer Thaddeus Mackowitz from Iowa Heights Police Department. All of the victims were notified of the date and time of sentencing. The state also had the opportunity to speak with the victims prior to the plea. And it is the state's understanding that based on what took place during this incident, all of the officers are in favor of the defendant being sentenced to prison. They do not want her to get a slap on the wrist due to the significance of the danger she put everyone in. Being that this was, the first count is failure to comply felony of the third degree, it is necessary for the court to go through the findings to establish that it should have been a felony of the third degree in the first place. So going through those factors, it is necessary to consider the duration of the pursuit. This pursuit was 25 minutes long. The distance of the pursuit is the second factor. It was 18.69 miles that were traveled by the defendant. The rate of speed at which the offender operated the motor vehicle during the pursuit, she reached the top speed of 96 miles per hour, but it is also noteworthy that when she was running stop signs, at one point she ran a stop sign going 35 miles per hour, and at another point she ran a stop sign going between 40 and 45 miles per hour. Another factor is whether the offender failed to stop for traffic lights or stop signs during the pursuit. That is a yes. She ran three stop signs and two red lights during this incident. Another factor is whether the offender operated the motor vehicle during the pursuit without lighted lights during time when lighted lights are required. This happened around 6 p.m., so that is not applicable here. Another factor is whether the offender committed moving violations during the pursuit, and that is yes. She also drove left of center, and the number of moving violations the state indicates is over 7 different types of moving violations. The last factor is whether it's to consider all relevant factors indicating that the offender's conduct is more serious than conduct normally constituting the offense. Here, she was driving and fleeing from the police during rush hour traffic around 6 p.m. on a Friday. This was on March 22nd. This was on I-71 and I-490 on busy city streets on Cleveland's east side. She narrowly missed striking two of the police officers as they were outside of their vehicles, and she is responsible for 4 vehicles being hit. The damage that she did rose to the restitution, is in regards to the restitution of over $26,000, $26,660.69 total. Most of that is due to damage to the trooper's vehicle, who had to make physical contact with her vehicle 3 times on purpose to finally get her to stop. And one of the times when she struck the Newburgh Heights officer's car, that also resulted in that vehicle hitting another officer's vehicle. So